A video camera feeds images to a television monitor. It dissects the field of view into an electronic signal. The monitor then reconverts this back into an image on its screen. When the camera points toward the monitor's screen, images are fed back into the camera and circulate around this closed loop. In the following video feedback experiments, an analog image processor is connected in the electronic portion of the feedback loop. It consists of modules to add, multiply, and synchronize images. In its programming and parallel operation, the system is very similar in architecture to a conventional analog computer, except that it simulates spatially extended dynamical systems. The camera is mounted to rotate on its optical axis. This is centered on the monitor's screen. Zooming in, as unity spatial magnification is reached, dynamic patterns spontaneously emerge. During one circuit of the feedback loop, an image is manipulated by various optical and electronic transformations. Their composite effect during one video frame time determines the overall dynamics. Dynamical systems theory pictures the behavior of any system as the motion of a point in a space of states. In video feedback, a state is a single image. The temporal evolution of patterns is represented then by a trajectory moving through the state space. Energy flows through the video feedback system and is dissipated. This process is analogous to friction in a mechanical oscillator. Dissipation causes an initial pattern to evolve through a transient phase into a small region of the state space, called the attractor. Attractors fall into a hierarchy of distinct behavioral classes based on their complexity. Fixed points and limit cycles describe regular, repetitive dynamics, whereas chaotic attractors describe unpredictable behavior. A fixed point corresponds to the conventional notion of equilibrium, a single static pattern toward which nearby initial patterns tend. These nearby patterns are said to be in the fixed point's basin of attraction. After perturbing a system away from its attractor, the trajectory returns. Here, the reddish light in the lower left comes from a flashlight that distorts the pattern, attempting to drive the system away from its attractor. But once removed, the original fixed point cross pattern returns. The pattern can be so distorted that the resultant image is closer to and lies in the basin of another attractor. A limit cycle attractor describes periodic behavior. In the state space, the sequence of patterns is visited repetitively. This sequence, for example, repeated exactly as shown for several hours, and when perturbed, returned to the cycle after a short transient. The following six examples illustrate some of the more complex video feedback dynamics. The interdigitated light and dark fingers of video dislocations are reminiscent of the convection cell patterns found in fluid flows. Similar patterns occur in viscous fingering in ferrofluids, domains in thin two-dimensional magnets, flux patterns in type 2 superconductors, and the ocular dominance patterns in the visual cortex. The mechanism at work here is called lateral inhibition, where light in one area inhibits light in neighboring regions. A natural consequence of rotation and magnification is the appearance of logarithmic spirals. This sequence illustrates two-dimensional crystal-like patterns of dots. At several times as the system relaxes, the dots align themselves along logarithmic spirals in a pattern identical to that found in sunflower phyllotaxis. With large spatial magnification and light gain, the video dynamics becomes very sensitive to small, uncontrolled fluctuations. If a fluctuation of sufficient size occurs, it becomes amplified to macroscopic, observable behavior. In this sequence, note that although the bursting behavior appears quite random, there are only several characteristic amplification pathways, for example, a grain texture pattern, and a sequence of growing balls. In this sequence, fluctuations at the top are amplified as they move down the screen, giving a fluidity and capriciousness typical of a stream or waterfall. In contrast to spirals, pinwheels have straight radial boundaries that rotate about the center. Here, on each pass through the feedback loop, the patterns are rotated and the three colors are cyclically mapped into each other. This is a simpler example where a dark region maps into a light region, and a light into dark. The camera is also rotated 90 degrees, giving an overall fourfold symmetry. Intermediate between logarithmic spirals and pinwheels are spiral waves reminiscent of the spatial patterns found in oscillating chemical reactions. The video system in this regime is an active medium, every point of which has a well-defined and synchronized oscillation, except for the phase singularity at the center. The next three sequences examine the effect of a slow change in a parameter on the dynamics. To isolate the effect of camera angle on the overall symmetry of the patterns, in this sequence, the camera is very slowly rotated through approximately 5 degrees. Additionally, a mask has been placed over the monitor to impose annular boundary conditions. The pattern symmetries lock and unlock as the camera passes through simple rational angles. Thank you. fixing the camera at an angle where a fourfold and a higher symmetry coexist but are marginally stable, chaotic sequences of patterns sporadically transit between the symmetries, their competition driving the unpredictability. The second bifurcation example illustrates the appearance of a stationary pinwheel pattern. The control parameter here is the light gain, that is, the amount of light amplification during one pass around the feedback loop. This is varied simply by increasing the camera's f-stop. Initially, diffuse boundaries appear between the light and dark regions. At higher light gain, they become quite distinct boundaries. A cubic nonlinear element is connected in the electronic portion of the feedback loop. Each picture element's intensity is operated on with a cubic one-dimensional map. Continuing as in the previous sequence, the light gain is increased and the system visits more and more the electronic processing's nonlinearity. The simple static pattern gives way to finer spatial structure and time-dependent dynamics. Eventually, the behavior becomes quite complex when spatial coherence is lost, an analog of the transition to fully developed turbulence.